and welcome to Life in Envelopes. I am Jennifer Bleacher. This channel is all about planning, budgeting, paying off debt, and my exciting journey from full-time teacher to full-time Etsy shop owner slash YouTuber. So if that is something that you would like to see, then please subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you along on this journey. Today, we're going to do my long-awaited, highly requested video of a new office tour. I've recently moved into my family's sunroom and have made it my new office, YouTube recording studio, Etsy shop, factory, all the stuff. So I'm just going to quickly give you a tour about everything in my office. First of all, I have a lot of awesome artwork in here that I'm just so happy to have. For example, this painting here was done by my brother when he was in college. He did a series of angel paintings, so I got one of those. And a lot of the stuff I got, I inherited from my parents because I've talked about this. They are selling their house in Des Moines to move to Michigan. So they have two houses full of furniture. So they're downsizing, and I got a lot of amazing stuff from them. And this is one of the things I got from them. So over here, I have a couple of pieces of art from my brother. These are, David's filming for me. David, what medium do you think he used? I know he used cereal boxes.
That's cardboard. So cereal boxes, yeah, with ink and white gel pen.
Okay, so he does have an Etsy shop, and I will link it below. And those are the types of items that he sells on his Etsy shop. He also does carvings on. They're so cool. I actually have one over here. I'll show you. I haven't framed this one yet. I have my budget mom stuff. Yeah, I have a couple here. I have, can you see, is the lighting okay? So I have this one, and then this one of David that he did. So these are some of the pieces of art that he makes that's available on his Etsy shop. Sorry, I'm gonna come back over here. So this storage unit here, I inherited this from my family. We lived in Germany for a long time when I was a kid, I think 3 or 4 years. Because my dad was in the military. So this is from Germany from my childhood, so it's very special to me. I'm glad I got that. This is Old Faithful. I have 3 Silhouette machines, and this is the one that I can always rely on. When the other ones are acting up, this one always does the job for me. So it's the only one I trust to be Bluetooth. The rest are plugged in, hardwired to the computer, which I'll show you in a minute. This is my printer, and actually, I'm thinking about switching from toner to ink. David and I have been working on that, trying to figure that out. But I'm actually in the middle of doing orders, so I have some here on here that I need to take over to my Silhouette machines to cut. So over here are my plants. Just this table is from Hawaii. I was born in Honolulu, Hawaii. My parents got this when they were there, and I inherited it. I didn't really have any place for it here, and my mom suggested I put it in the corner and put plants on it. I thought that was a great idea because I love plants. So I have this one here. I named her Lily. And funny story, I told David I named her Lily, but she's not a lily. And then I found out she actually is a lily. So this is Lily, and this is Pretty Little Things, who is trying to grow. She's doing really, really well, or they are doing really, really well. Okay, so this is another table that I inherited from my mom, and it's stainless steel with tempered glass on top, and this is amazing because before she gave this to me, when I was processing orders, I was at a low table like this, so I was bent over processing orders, and it was very hard on my back, but here I can process orders standing up, and I love that. Right here, these 4 little ladies are very special to me. Something else I inherited from my mom. She had those, her grandfather and her great-grandfather were both businessmen and did a lot of business trading in different Asian countries. So she had a lot of Asian things in her house when I was growing up, our house. And I remember like cleaning those all the time when I was a kid. And I loved them. It was fun to clean them because they're like little dolls, and I got to keep them now that she's moving. Okay, over here is a very special piece of artwork by Laura Zombie. This is a print directly from her. David Thank you, David. Gave that to me as a Valentine's gift this year. I've always loved that painting. When I originally saw it, I saw it as me leaving the corporate world to become a teacher. And it's just, and it's still significant today. Can you show them again? Because now it's like me leaving the teaching world to do my own thing and live out my dream of having my own business. So it's very, very special to me. I love that painting. This here is the dog's crate because this room used to be the dog's room and they still sleep in here at least for a couple hours a night, don't you think?
Yeah.
Because David puts them in
around 11:45 p.m.
Okay, and then I let it out about 3 or 4 a.m. So they're not in that long. But they just feel safer. Like once everyone else is asleep, they feel safer in here than just being out alone. This is my filming desk. I got this from Etsy and I believe it's in my storefront. If it's not, then I'll make sure and go and add it to my storefront. Oh, don't show them too much. Spoiler. I'm working on that. So that's a video that's gonna be coming out sometime soon. I'm working on revamping our sinking fund, so that's what that is there. But I have a ring light, I have all my supplies. So over here, I have two sticker books of my, these are my, what are they called? Functional stickers, and here are my months of the year stickers. I have my other stickers over there, but, good job, David. But these are the ones I'm always needing, so I just have them right here where close to my workstation. And then here's just our extra paper supply. We have sticker paper, regular paper, shipping label paper, David's paper for his prints. We'll be having an Etsy shop at some point in the future, right?
Yep.
Right now he just, I don't know, what are you using it for?
Doing prints for, lately I've been doing prints for other artists. There's an artist who's having a surgery and she asked for artists to contribute for prints for an auction. Aww. So she could afford it. It was like $6,000 she had to raise.
If you have a link for me, to that auction, can you give to me? I can include it in the description box.
Yeah, I'll check. I think it's a private auction, but I'll check.
Oh, okay. Okay. So then here I have a second ring light. This is the one I use when I'm filming by myself and I want to film my face. This ring light stand. It holds my phone. This here is just a table for extra storage. This is my old filming table, actually, but I used to use a mat. Oh, here's the mat that I used to use on it. Now it protects these machines from extra light because they are very sensitive to light. So I just have this table here for extra storage of my stuff, and there's more stuff stored below. This is our backyard. Should I open it or not?
Yeah, sure.
Because the
dogs will run in.
But I love it during the day. I just closed.
Only one came in.
Mindy. Oh, sorry, Mark. Go ahead. So I closed this. Kind of like you, Mindy. And it's nice because it's like right now the weather is beautiful and I just love the fresh air. And there's like a little tear at the bottom. Doggy created tear. But it works. The dogs can come in and out as much as they want. So I'm just leaving it like that for now. So back over here. It took me a long time to get to a place where these machines were happy. Like, I had to figure out the perfect distance from top to bottom, from the light source to here, everything. They are now in the perfect position and they work almost all the time. Like 99% of the time, which is huge. I know, right? Oh, we've been through a lot of drama with silhouettes. But I did install these lights with, there's just like track lighting and I put them on here with tape, like mounting tape, and it's super strong and it holds really well. So this protects it from that light. I also have this blackout curtain here to protect it from sunlight, and I always keep that shade closed as well because they're very sensitive to light. Okay, here is my computer and everything. Here's some orders I'm working on, so don't show the address. Here's my current planner. I have it open next to me so I can check things off as I accomplish them. And here's my beautiful Life in Envelope sign. This is from a steel company, and I think it's called Steelworks, but If I can, oh, Steel Roots. It's called Steel Roots. I will put a link to their website down below as well. Sorry, Mindy is licking David's leg. It's so funny. Oh, and then the last thing, the doggies have a little, like, they're a little nook here where they have food and water because this is their room and we're sharing it, and this is their food bin, which we need to refill soon. I think that's it. These are extra stickers, extra planners, just extra stuff. Okay, how do I do? Oh, wait, did you already do it?
Do what?
Did you already turn it off?
No.
Okay, and then I got this one sign here that I love. She believed she could, so she did. Okay, thanks, baby.
All right, I'm never stopping filming. This is gonna go on forever. No.